Do you know when you see a car so often that it almost becomes invisible to you? Well, that has happened to me and the Ford EcoSport until driving it this weekend, and then I just saw them everywhere. I was like, is there any street corner, any parking lot, any garage, anything without an EcoSport in it? And I was like, no, I don't think there is. They are everywhere, and it's for good reason, okay? It is, and it was the best seller when it kind of, it became the bestseller when it sort of hit our shores back in 2013. And so recently, my aunt was looking for a car. She wants a car that she can sort of go away for the weekends with, but like still have around town and needs to maybe go on gravel road and, but doesn't have a budget of over sort of 350,000 rand and whatever, like most of us don't. And the EcoSport came up and I was like, yeah, you know, there's so many sort of game changers at the moment, like the sort of like Volkswagen T-Cross and the Hyundai Venue, etc., and the Mazda CX-3, which I love. But then I got given this Ford EcoSport automatic Ambiente, which is Ford's now brand new entry-level automatic, and it costs 306,700 rand, okay? So it's an affordable automatic. And I went up the West Coast in it to Paternoster. We had a lovely time, let me tell you. But I was left feeling really, really impressed with this again. And it sort of like ignited that little bit of like EcoSport charm and love that I have, or love that I have for its charm. Because it was actually a very lovely and very pleasant drive. And I, like I say, I was so surprised because I really thought I was going to dislike it. I thought I was going to be putting my foot flat and being like, like trying to overtake someone and everything. And I hate that. But I didn't. I had a fully loaded car with like booze and stuff. There was just like no sort of, I wasn't frustrated. I wasn't irritated. I was very comfortable when I arrived. I was comfortable when I get back. That's what you want from a car. My only problem, it's just too small. So sort of for my aunt, it's amazing because, you know, it's just her really, her and her husband, they go up to the West Coast, whatever. There's a lot of kids and a whole bunch of stuff or whatever. Do you know, so then that's really great. Like there's like legroom space. I mean, just look at the boot. Look what I put in there. And that was for a weekend away. And it just had two bags for us and some booze and some odds and ends. And already like, okay, squished. So not great. It's an entry level. So it still has like very cool spec, like Bluetooth and voice control, electric windows, and all that jazz. Like USB ports and all that things. But this infotainment system I don't love. If you're in the Trend or Titanium, you're going to get the bigger screen. It's a touchscreen. This is a non-touchscreen. I keep touching the screen because I've gotten used to that. That's my diva behavior. But yeah, I find it a bit like too simple. It doesn't always work. It's not that responsive. I'm having like major issues with it and I want to rip it out. Like that's how much it frustrates me. And we had a few issues with it being paired and listening to music and then it just stopping. And then we were like, eight, and then, but I mean, that could also be down to maybe our phones or something, who knows. Everything's going to be fine. And we're not together. Nope. And if it's all right. This car also offers, which is really cool, is the fact that you can go on a gravel road and stuff, and I even went on a bit of sand by mistake, and it was really quite fine. Do you know, it's got the higher ground clearance. That's why it makes it such a fun little sort of weekend car, because you are able to maybe sort of, you know, take a little bit of a detour if need be, or if you live on an estate or something like that, you know, kind of like most of its rivals, I guess. The engine that this six-speed auto is made to do is a 1.5-litre naturally aspirated petrol engine, 91 kilowatts of power, 151 newton-metres of torque. And it actually works really well together. I mean, who knew? I thought I was going to tell you to sort of like stretch your budget by like 40k and get the Trend automatic, because then you get the 1-litre EcoBoost, you know, it's got a little turbo and you get a little bit more spec or whatever. I don't know. I think I need to drive them back to back though. And maybe I feel like that was just like worlds ahead. But I can't imagine. I can't recall either, okay, guys? Like, I drive a lot of cars in between. I drive all these cars. But I actually found this absolutely adequate. And maybe if I had to go up more hills and stuff like that, if I was going up the garden route, maybe a bit different. But I don't know. I just really enjoy driving it. Like I say, it's just the space issue for me. But we had a marvelous time in Paternoster. We went kayaking where I think I almost died. Okay, it was pouring with rain. It was freezing cold. The swell was like the perfect storm. I know I'm being dramatic, but that's what it felt like at the time. Anyways, it was marvelous. Anyways, and I can tell you, a great hangover cure, because we'd gone to Chaiki for dinner and had all the wine. And so the next morning, we didn't drive, don't worry. We walked home. We then went kayaking and I felt marvelous after that because, you know, a near-death experience will probably do that to you. Or maybe just the fresh seawater and cold air.